Tonight's headlines are brought to you in part by Coldwell Energy and McDonald's.
Good evening, Commonwealth, and thanks for watching the Channel 2 News. I'm Sally Lemus. Let's take a look at tonight's top stories. House members respond back to the governor on their budget bill. Also tonight, lawmakers express their frustration with spending styles in the CNMI. And arrivals in the CNMI looking up. In sports, this young soccer gal believes in practice. Stay with us, we have these stories and more next.
Need a new phone? Trade in now and get up to $500 off our best 5G devices. Trade in your older phone in any condition and step up to better savings and speeds only our 5G network can provide. Check out our website and catch up on the best mobile experience. Trade in now. Docomo Pacific. Better together.
We've made a lot of breakfasts, and along the way, we noticed something was missing. A warm cinnamon roll for breakfast, or with breakfast. A fluffy blueberry muffin from the drive-thru you're already driving through. A glazed apple fritter, which might find its way into your coffee. These are options every breakfast haver should have, and now they do. Meet the new bakery sweets at McDonald's. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Day to the Wami and good evening, Commonwealth. Today is Friday, September 16, 2022. The House Ways and Means Committee met with media partners in the chambers this afternoon to, in their words, set the record straight. Let's take a look.
We would like to put out the facts and let the people decide who is telling the truth.
The House Ways and Means Committee stands firm with what they've proposed for the fiscal year 2023 budget. They say the governor is misinforming the public and there was nothing illegal in their proposal. In a press conference this morning, Chairman Donna Manglonia states they were challenged to identify funding to provide agencies with something to work with.
During our budget hearing with the Secretary of Finance, the committee was assured that when we got the revised budget submission, operational funding for departments and agencies would be addressed. However, that was not the case. What we found was that the operation budget were still zeroed out, and we could not, in good conscience, pass a budget that provided nothing at all for operations.
According to Representative Layla Stafler, the governor has left out information that justifies their reason to the bill.
Yes, we moved money around. That is our main job as legislators. in order to free up local money needed to pay for two very important things that were not budgeted by this governor at all. The retiree 25% and the Medicaid match, two of which were not included in his budget. In particular, both of those things cannot be paid by ARPA funds. And so in order to do so, we took the ARPA funds that were freed up and moved the money around within the departments to make sure that we had the $13 million out of that to pay for the retiree 25% and to make sure that we had that Medicaid match, which is a $10 million need, which that's $23 million. That's a lot of money.
Staffler says they were then able to fund the top two priorities that were allegedly zero funded by the governor and have money left over for operational funding.
What is not being told to the public is that what was replaced to make sure that those negatives go back to positive is that we used ARPA money. They're claiming that we don't have the authority to use ARPA money to do that kind of process. But as stated by our colleague, Representative Magofnia, in one Title I CMC Section 7204 Part B, it is actually an allowable process for a legislature to do. When there is additional revenues, the legislature can appropriate it.
She also says there are still some agencies that haven't received their money.
Governor Ralph Torres says that he supports education, but based on the information in our subpoena dissus tecum, he has not supported NMC. NMC has only received 17%, a little over 500K of the $3 million in general funds that they were allocated in this year's budget. On top of that, NMC has not received $1.3 million in ARPA. They were promised. And they have not received the $1 million of SNIL funding that we allocated to them earlier this fiscal year. So in total, that's $4.8 million that NMC has not received and has been waiting for since the fiscal year began.
In a press briefing last week, the governor said that not only did the legislature slash funding for several government agencies, but they also increased their budget by $1.2 million. But according to Representative Selena Babauta, their budget was reduced from $9.3 million down to $8.9
million. We reduced every single member of the legislature, including the Senate, their office allocations by $5,000, and other cuts were made as well to the legislature. The governor, in his FY23 proposal, did not allocate any ARPA funds for the legislature. So all of this is coming from the local revenues. We were trying to match our current level for this fiscal year, but we knew we needed to make sacrifices at the legislature. So we did. We were responsible and we took a $5,000 cut, and we all agreed to that, including the minority members.
Babauta adds that while they took a cut in salary, cabinet members were given a raise.
The governor again failed to reveal to the public that he intended to raise his cabinet and special assistants. And I want to take note that the largest proposed salary increase goes to the Secretary of Finance. The governor proposed a $30,000 increase on top of his base salary.
Representative Vicente Camacho.
Mr. Governor, we have not called you a liar. So my question to you is, if you are not lying, then who is lying for you? You also asked in your statement to me, who in your cabinet received salary increases? Mr. Governor, if you don't know who in your cabinet received salary increases, then you're being misinformed by your own executive body.
The legislature has 14 days to submit a balanced budget bill to the governor to be signed into law for the upcoming fiscal year to avoid a government shutdown.
Recent budget talks with Governor Torres and Finance Secretary David Attalick include their request to the legislature to create revenue-generating bills to fill in gaps in the budget and bring in some new money. Lawmakers take this time to respond to the statements in a press conference this afternoon.
I made one this year and it got vetoed. I worked with the Department of Commerce about it and it got vetoed. I think that maybe he should consider not putting politics involved and vetoing good bills that would be revenue generating.
It doesn't matter how many revenue-generating bills we introduce and is passed and is law. If the governor cannot take responsibility and spend the money wisely, you know, and not spend it like there's no tomorrow, it doesn't matter. We can bring billions of dollars every year, but if you're not fiscally responsible with the money, it really defeats the purpose. So he can throw that at us all day long, and it wouldn't matter, because he needs to take a deep look in where he spends his money and ask himself whether or not those expenditures are really critical, they're essential, and whether or not the entire public is going to benefit from those expenditures.
It's absurd to put everything to the House to somehow come up with the shortfalls. There's no funding for the retirees, so guess what? House members, Senate, you guys have to think of some way to come up with $15 million. Okay, well, how will we get IPI to pay what they owe, for starters? The governor constantly tries to call us out and say, generate some revenue, come up with a bill. Again, do we raise fees? No, it's gonna hurt our people. We don't do that. We try to ensure that our people who are barely surviving get the help that they need right now. That's what we've all been advocating for this whole time.
The upward tourist trend continues in the CNMI.
According to the Marianas Visitors Authority, visitor arrivals for the month of August increased by 1,669%. The CNMI had 551 visitors in August of 2021. This August, 9,700 visitors arrived in the NMI. MVA says more than 61,000 visitors have come to the Marianas so far this fiscal year. August's figure is about one-third the number of average monthly arrivals prior to the pandemic, but it's a significant mark of the TRIP program implementation. MVA counts a total of 8,000 visitors arriving from South Korea in the past 8 months, compared to 94 over the same period last fiscal year. There were 75 flights to the Marianas in August, although a rising increase of positive COVID cases in Korea are making people hesitant to fly. Additionally, the Korean won continues to fall further against the dollar, costing Korean visitors more to purchase the same amount of service compared to before the pandemic. The CNMI received 148 visitors from Japan in August this year, compared to only one Japanese visitor in August of last year. The three weekly flights from Narita to Saipan by United Airlines will run for 6 months in attempt to stabilize the Japan market. Japan faces the same challenges as Korea as they are seeing their seventh wave of COVID and a weak Japanese yen.
Coming up, government officials and community members conduct a motorcade in remembrance of 9/11. Stay tuned.
Looking around for some yachts, man! Sue Lin Foundation promotes the culture of giving back. The foundation and its generous partners are committed to supporting programs that include health, education, and sports. Initiatives that promote arts and culture, the environment, and tourism will benefit our community and our residents. Giving back and making a difference will help ensure that the island paradise we call home will be a better place to live.
At one of Saipan's beaches, this mother lays about 100 eggs under the cover of darkness. She hides her nest as best she can and then slowly makes her way back to the ocean. The eggs hatch and the babies head for the sea where they will face a daily dose of danger. Just 1 in 1,000 will make it to adulthood. Those that do will one day lay their own eggs. Sea turtles are protected under CNMI law. If you see one that is stranded or if you see illegal activity, call the hotline at 287-8537.
Welcome back to the Channel 2 News. The SBDC Seed to Sell event, initially scheduled for tonight, is postponed until further notice.
According to the Small Business Development Center Network, to better serve the community, the organizing committee has decided to expand the Seed to Sell program by including a new category to the competition. Businesses that have been in operation for more than a year now are eligible to compete and present their ideas. Initially, the program was open to aspiring business starters, but after much deliberation, they will allow existing businesses to participate. The Seed to Sell competition invites business owners to submit proposals for business or product ideas that meet the current needs within the product or service industry. Submissions will be judged on uniqueness, innovation, relevant business experience, measurable expected results, and why their business should be considered. The organizing committee will announce the new event date and official requirements early next week. Competitors who qualified in the first round of applications will maintain their finalist standing. For more information, you can email seedtosell@marianas.edu.
Over the weekend, hundreds of first responders, frontliners, and community members drove around Saipan, honoring victims of 9/11 and the heroes of that day.
September is proclaimed as We Will Never Forget Field of Heroes Month, and the community is encouraged to express appreciation to CNMI first responders and military service members for being our everyday heroes.
Woo!
And where we have sports up next.
Need a new phone? Trade in now and get up to $500 off our best 5G devices. Trade in your older phone in any condition and step up to better savings and speeds only our 5G network can provide. Check out our website and catch up on the best mobile experience. Trade in now. Docomo Pacific, better together.
Golfers, come north and practice your game at the Marianas Driving Range. New Year's local specials. 10-piece coupon books available for just $60. That's a $10 savings. Want to get really good? Come work on your swing every day for just $99 per month. It's our practice pass and you're going to love it. Grab your passes and go straight to the range. You can social distance and chip all at the same time and the views are free. Reserve now at marianastrekking.com. You can pay online, open 7 days a week.
Tonight's sports brought to you in part by Tan Holdings through the Tan Soo Lim Foundation, making communities a better place to live.
Buenas sports fans.
A lot of athletes stay in the game for not just their passion, but for the opportunities that come with it. This young girl is well aware of the possibilities of hard work and practice.
There are more important things in life than winning or losing a game. A quote by Lionel Messi.
Young Star Shining, brought to you by the Tan Soo Lim Foundation.
Another member of the NMI Women's National Soccer Team, a sophomore from Marianas High School, Tamia Hicks, is our young star for tonight.
My name's Tamia Hicks. I'm 15 years old. I'm a sophomore at Marianas High School.
Hicks has been playing for the Tan Holdings Football Club before joining the national team 2 years ago.
When my mom picked up like sports, because I didn't know like which team to join, but like my friend Kaylin, she introduced me to Tan Holdings. That's when I joined the club team around seven years old, I think.
She loves being in the soccer field and she also enjoys spending time with her friends and teammates.
I don't know, I just enjoyed it a lot because I like really got used to like being around like teammates, and I love like being able to be here in the field, you know, kicking a ball around under the sun, getting that vitamins in, and yeah.
They were in Guam last month for a week-long soccer training. Their game against the men's team was a good training and experience.
It was honestly like the first game was honestly really surprising because we got to go against the boys, which was I think it was good because it was challenging and we were able to like get like a lot of experience in, and playing against boys is like really, really intense.
Having good stamina and a technique in hitting the ball are very important in playing soccer.
Because I feel like if you have like so much skill but you have no like you have no stamina, I feel like you can't go as long. Like yeah, having skill is good, but I think having like the fitness and the agility and speed to play the sport is it's advanced. Like it gives you an advantage there.
Hicks also plays basketball and she just joined the NMI national basketball team.
Oh yes, I recently joined NMI basketball, but like I'm not as good at it as I am in soccer, but I'm getting there, you know, practice makes improvement.
According to Hicks, playing sports is very important, especially for young people like her.
Because sports can take you anywhere. Like if you're having a hard time in school and like, you know, if you feel like you can't make it like as high as other people, like universities or like outs, like in the, like off island, then I think soccer could be like a really, it's a big help for like to go off island, play college soccer or any sport.
Practice makes improvement, and that is her advice to all the young athletes out there.
It takes a lot of time to perfect, or not to perfect, but to improve on what you really wanna, like, well, like what you're passionate about, like in the sport. Like for me, I don't think practice makes perfect. I think practice makes improvement.
Young Star Shining, brought to you by the Tan Soo Lin Foundation.
Sing along to your favorite hits with live music from the Gigolos. Godfather's has daily food and drink specials, like Taco Tuesdays. The best pizza on island every day of the week. Located on Palm Street in Garrison. Everybody is family at Godfather's Bar. Bada bing, bada boom.
Hi, I'm Dre, one of the personal trainers here at Gold's Gym, and today we're gonna show you a Bulgarian split squat, a fantastic lower body exercise that should be a main staple in your training. Now, the first thing we wanna address is the rear foot placement. Now, whether it's toes on or toes off, just find what's comfortable for you. The bigger issue we want to tackle is the height of the box or bench. You see, when you set up on a box or a bench that's too high, that inherently puts an aggressive stretch on the front of your hip. Oftentimes, that sensation will take away from the working leg, the leg that's on the floor. And when you start to add load in this faulty position, you're bound to run into some problems, particularly if you got some mobility restrictions. So Jamila's gonna set up. She's gonna descend with control, and from there, just stand tall.
And for the KSPN weather report, mostly cloudy with scattered showers and thunderstorms. South wind 7 to 11 miles per hour tonight, mostly cloudy with scattered showers and thunderstorms. Southwest wind 6 to 9 miles per hour, becoming west-northwest in the evening. High 86, low 76, the humidity 84%. Tomorrow, partly sunny with scattered showers and thunderstorms. West wind 3 to 7 miles per hour, high 87, low 76. The marine forecast, mainly gentle winds are expected across the Marianas in the next few days as monsoon flow weakens. Combined seas of 7 to 9 feet will persist through tonight, failing between 6 and 8 feet for the weekend. South wind 5 to 10 knots, wind waves 2 feet or less, northwest swell 7 to 9 feet. The sunrise will be at 6.05 a.m., high tide 11 p.m., low tide 6.02 p.m., and the sunset, you can catch that at 6.18 p.m. All right, folks, there you have it. That is your Friday edition of the New Sports and Weather here in the Marianas. We thank you so much for watching. We hope you have a great night and a great weekend, and we'll see you back here on Monday.